Let's revise. Starting topic of chapter 6, geography, human resource. So what is the human resource? Human resource is the ultimate resource, and people are the nation's greatest resource. Okay, so everything, the natural resource convert into a resource only because of human resource. The distribution of population is not evenly distributed over the world, because the distribution of population affect by different geographical factor like topography, climate, soil, water, minerals, and social, cultural, economic factors which affect the distribution of population. Now today our topic is population change. As you know, the number of people in an area does not remain same. It keeps changing. The population change refers the number change in number of people during a specific time, a particular phase. So the world population has not been stable. Okay, it increased and manifold, many levels, because it affected by three main things. So these are birth rate, death rate, and migration. Due to the change in the birth rate or due to the change in the death rate, the population change. If the birth rate increase or death rate decrease, so the population increase of that area. If the birth rate decrease and death rate also increase, so it decrease the population of the area. If birth rate decrease and death rate decrease, so it is same. Okay, but if the people migrate in other area and death rate increase and birth rate reduce decrease, so it decrease the that area population. So let's have a look. If we compare with the early time before 50 years back, so if we compare with the medical facility, educational facility, the way of living, the death rate increased that time. But now the medical facility are very good and the food facility is very good. Everyone, the food is available for all. But early time, the food was the farmer which growth of production is not according to the population. So in the lack of food or lack of good medical facility, so that rate that time was increased. So as I told you, that due to medical facility, the people are conscious about their health. Now the people are health conscious, and the good sufficient food are available to all. So the population increased drastically. If we compare with the 1800s, the world population grew steadily but slowly. There was no proper health facility. Sufficient food was not available to all the people. So the farmer were not able to grow the meat, the food requirement of the people. So the growth of the population is very low. In 1804, the birth population reached 1 billion. If we, after 50 years, what happened? In 1959, the world population reached 3 billion. And in a very short period of time, 40 years later, the world population reached 6 billion. So it is known as a population explosion. What was the main reason of this population explosion? The good health facility. Availability of water, food, availability of clean and drinking water, pure drinking water. So these are increase the birth rate and decrease the death rate. So in this way, it increase the population, growth of population. So there is a difference between birth rate and the death rate can be measured or can be known as the natural growth rate. Now, how we measure the birth rate? So for the measure, the birth rate are usually measured as the number of live birth per 1000 person. For example, if 1840 mein 1000 logon ke upar 10 log bade, so that is the increase amount that is known as birth rate. and the death rate is usually measured the death rate number of death per 1000 people कि 1000 लोगों में कितनी लोग डेथ हुई, डिक्रीज हुई है या इंक्रीज हुई है. सो दैट इज सो एंड द डिफरेंस बिटवीन देम दैट इज नोन एज नेचुरल ग्रोथ रेट. नाउ व्हाट इज द माइग्रेशन? माइग्रेशन इज आल्सो वन वेरी मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्टर ऑफ पॉपुलेशन चेंज. सो द मूवमेंट ऑफ पीपल फ्रॉम वन कंट्री टू अनदर और पीपल इन और आउट इन एरिया दैट इज नोन एज माइग्रेशन. इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट ओनली द माइग्रेशन इज आउटसाइड द कंट्री or internationally level. No, in inside country also it is going. When the rural people are migrated to urban area, so it increase the population of urban area. Why they migrated to urban area? Because of the medical facility ko lekar, education ko lekar, in many reason behind it, for security purpose, for better lifestyle, they moved toward urban area. And same way the people migrated one country to another. Like if you take an example of Sudan. So the Sudan, many people migrated from Sudan to other country. So those people migrate, those leave a country. A people who leave a country known as immigrate. And those people join the country, other country, arrive our country, that is known as immigrants. So the immigrants number of people in USA and Australia are very large, because if we talk about Australia personally, so the Australia don't have their own citizen. Immigrants people are, the number of immigrants are large. And Sudan are the example of country that experienced loss of population number due to out migration or immigration. Okay, fine. Immigration here can you can see when a person enter a new country or immigrate when a person leave country. So Sudan people, those leave their Sudan for the Sudan country, they are immigrants. But when they reach arrive other country, so these people are immigrant for that country. So the migration is another factor to change in population. Here you can understand the pattern of population change. Yes. Pattern of population change is very important, because by only because of it we come to know the quality of population. The quality of population means the nature of that particular country population. The population, the people of that country are literate, educated hai ya nahi hai, they are healthy or not. The gender of that country population is the female are higher or the male are lower, or the male are higher, the female are less in comparatively men. So through the pattern of population change we come to know. For the population change we make the composition of population. Let's know population composition. Yes. So the population composition, because through that we make a few slab, the age, their age slab, their sex slab, their literacy slab. If we compare the country, the country is crowded, so we think about that crowded country don't develop because they have a huge population. But it is not like that. If we compare the crowded, too crowded, both country having a crowd huge population, Japan and Bangladesh, both country having a huge population, but the quality of population is very much important, because if the quality of population, quality of people is good, so that country the factor, the huge population is not affect its development. Okay, like Japan, the country, the Japanese people are more talented, skillful, literate, or life conscious, health conscious people. And same other way, if we take example of Bangladesh, with a huge population, but the people are not bothered about their education, medical facility, and other. So the development of the both country are very large gap between their development. The Japan is developed country, where than the Bangladesh, because the Japan take its huge population as a human resource, not as a resource, not as a burden. They trained their people, they educate their people, they give a good education facility, food facility. Okay, So in this way, you should understand through this example the importance of human resource for the development of the country. It is not like that if the population is huge of any country, so it means that country cannot develop. No. That is depend on their policy, their parameter. If the country take the population as a human resource, not as a burden, so they can utilize that resource. Okay? So understand the people as a resource, and we need to know about their qualities. People are varying indifferently in their sex level, in literacy level, and age group, occupational and income level. Now let us understand the composition of population, which help us to know about the people of that country, because they divided the people of the country in different slabs, like age group, like the we understand this composition of people through the population pyramid. Why the population pyramid? Which tell us about the a sex group of that country. Like they divided the population different groups. Like first group is a 5 to 9, then 9, 10 to 14. So the two group of the population dependent group, the young dependent and elder dependent. Young dependent like you, and the elder dependent, yeah, like your grandfather. Those are above the 64 of age, and those are below the 18 of age. So they are, those are below the age of 18, and those are above the age of 64, they are two dependent group in a country. And the working group are the between that age group is a working, like we people, your parents. So please read this, Aran, this conversation between two girls. Now you can see the three these three pyramid, population pyramid of three countries. We can understand all three are different to each other. The pyramid of Kenya, the pyramid of India, and the pyramid of Japan. So the population pyramid also tell us how many dependent group are there in the country. So there are the two group, the dependents, young dependent and elder dependent. Young dependent age group below 15 years, or elderly age over 64, 65. And the working, those are between these group, the people coming in this group. The population pyramid of the country in which birth and death rate both are high, as you can see in this group, this pyramid, the population pyramid of Kenya. The blue area shows us male section, and the orange female section. Okay, so you can see the birth rate and death rate, the base is broad. Base is broad because it is show that both is high, the death rate is high and birth rate is high. And the base and rapidly, if you observe this, it narrow toward the top. It is narrow toward the top if you compare with the base. What it shows us? Because many children are born, large percentage of them die in their infancy. Look at here. Itni age par aakar mar gaye log. Itne janam hote hote mar gaye. Death rate, this is show. Relatively few become adults, and there are very few old people. This situation typed by the pyramid shows for Kenya. In country where death rate amongst the very young are decreasing, the pyramid brought younger age group because more infants survive at childhood. Still it is broad. Okay, such population contain this can be seen in your India pyramid, where the children survive because of good medical facility. Such population contain relatively large number of young people, and which means strong expanded labor force. In country like Japan, see this figure number 6.9, low birth rate make the pyramid narrow at the base. birth rate is low and the death rate is also low. And decreased death rate allow number people to reach old age. You can see. So skilled, fitted, and hopeful young people into it with a positive outlook are the future of any nation. We in India are fortunate to have a such resource. We have our country having a huge population, so we have a huge human resource. They must be educated and provide skill opportunity to become able and protected. So we should think about how to participate in the development of our country. We should think about it. I hope it is understood by all. Thank you.